Can we measure the speed of this bullet using just this block and a string? Well, the answer is yes. It may sound insane, but still, let's see how to do that. So we have this bullet coming towards this block, and as it comes closer to the block, it strikes a block like this, and because of that, the block and the bullet, they start moving forward, and they move like this, and at the maximum height point, they come to a state of rest. Now this is the whole situation, what's happening, but let's rewind, let's come back. So we have the bullet which is coming towards the block, and we are interested in figuring out the velocity of this bullet. Let's call that u. Let's say that the mass of the bullet is small m, and the mass of this big block, this is capital M. When the bullet strikes a block like this, now both the bullet and the block, they start moving forwards, let's say with a velocity of v. And in this interaction, in this collision, when the bullet strikes a block, there is one quantity which will be conserved, which is conserved in every collision, whether it is elastic or inelastic, and that is momentum of the bullet and the block system, that's really conserved. So how can we express conservation of momentum mathematically? We can say that the initial momentum, we can say that pi, initial momentum, this is equal to the final momentum. And we are talking about the bullet and the block system here. So the initial momentum, that is only the momentum of the bullet, which is m into u, this is equal to the final momentum that will be for both the bullet and the block. So they become one, the bullet stops up till this point, they become one mass, and that mass is small m plus capital M into v. So u, the speed of the bullet, this is m plus capital M into v divided by small m. Now over here, we can start off by knowing some values, which is the mass of the bullet, we can measure that, the mass of the block, we can also measure that, but we don't know the speed with which both of them move. We don't know this v, right? So we cannot really calculate u. We would need to do something else. So for that, let's see what else is happening. We know after the collision, the block moves forward, both of them move forward, and they swing like a pendulum. They swing like a pendulum. They reach a certain height. We can show that like this from the center of this block. So they reach a certain height. We can call that h. And this is the height when this system of bullet and block, they come to a state of rest. So the final velocity here, that is zero. So they start off with some velocity and they reach a point when their velocity is zero. At the highest point, they have traveled a certain height of h, so they did gain some energy, right? This is gravitational potential energy. And where did this energy come from? Well, initially all they had was kinetic energy. So kinetic energy, all of this is being changed to gravitational potential energy. And we can express this mathematically. We can say that half into small m plus capital M v square, this is equal to small m plus capital M into h. This just gets cancelled off, and v comes out to be equal to under root of 2gh. There will be a g over here as well. Now you might be thinking that, well, I have seen examples where you throw a ball with a speed v, it reaches a certain height of h, and you can conserve energy over there, considering if you don't really consider air resistance and everything. So the idea over there is that when there is no external work being done, we can conserve energy between any two points. But here, is there no external work being done? Let's think about it. So this is a bullet, block, and an earth system. So the force of gravity is really an internal force, which is doing some work and giving some gravitational potential energy. But there is also one more other force. There is a force of tension, right? There is this force of tension. This is T. So isn't this doing any work? Isn't there an external force in the picture, in the bullet and the block and the earth system? Isn't this tension doing a work? So how can we conserve energy? Well, it turns out that as the block moves, this rope, it's always perpendicular to the direction in which the bullet and the block system moves. So somewhat like this, the curve, the arc, let's say the arc looks somewhat like this. So this rope is always really perpendicular to it, which means that the tension, the force of tension, is always perpendicular to the direction in which the block and the bullet is moving. And when force is perpendicular to displacement, we know that work done is always zero, because f dot d, ft cos theta, theta is 90. So work done due to the tension force, that's really zero. There is no external work done, so we can conserve energy. And when we do that, we get this velocity v with which the block and the bullet started off. That is under root of 2gh. Now, one other thing, really, we would just know the length of the string usually, but there is a bit of a math there. We can calculate, we can, using some trigonometry, we can figure out this height h. But let's say you are using some camera, you take a snapshot when the bullet and the block comes to a state of rest. And because of that, you are able to measure this height h. So let's say we know the maximum height that the block and the bullet reaches. Okay, so we know h, we know g, and when we substitute this v over here, then what do we get? Let's see. U, this is equal to small m plus capital M into, this is under root of 2gh divided by small m. Now let's put in some numbers to get a better feel of it. Usually bullet is 70 grams, mass, let's say this is 1 kilogram, and the height is 30 meters. So when we replace these values over here, and when we work out U will come out to be approximately 458 meters per second. And that is how one can measure the speed of a bullet using nothing but just one block and a piece of string.